Very good morning. Today I am going to explain about the transfer function of armature controlled DC motor. The circuit diagram of the armature controlled DC motor is shown here. Here the field voltage is kept constant and you are going to vary the armature voltage. That is, the speed of the motor can be controlled either by varying the armature voltage or by varying the field voltage. In this, armature voltage is varied and field voltage is kept constant. The speed of the DC motor is directly proportional to armature voltage and inversely proportional to flux in field winding. In armature controlled DC motor, the desired speed is obtained by varying the armature voltage. The speed control system is an electromechanical control system and it is shown as this circuit diagram. Let RA be the armature resistance, LA be the armature inductance, IA be the armature current, VA armature voltage, EB back EMF, KT is the torque constant, T is the torque developed by motor, theta is the angular displacement of shaft, J is the momentum of inertia of motor and load, B is the frictional coefficient of motor and load, KB is the back EMF constant. When armature voltage is varied, this is the circuit diagram where the current, armature current, is flowing across the resistor, that is RA, and LA is the armature inductance and EB is the back EMF. Whenever current flows across the coil that is placed in a magnetic field, due to the cutting of the magnetic flux, this back EMF will be generated. We know that the current, that is the voltage across the resistance, is given as IA into RA. The voltage across the inductance is LA into DIA by DT, and EB is the back EMF across the motor. So here we are going to apply the Kirchhoff voltage law, which states that the total voltage across the system will be equal to the individual voltages. So by Kirchhoff voltage law, we can write as IA into RA plus LA into DIA by DT plus EB will be equal to the armature voltage. The torque of DC motor is always proportional to the product of flux and current. Since flux is constant in this system, the torque is proportional to the current, that is the armature current alone. So torque will be proportional to IA. So torque will be equal to KT into IA, where KT is the torque constant. The final output will be the rotation of the motor, so that is the angular displacement of the motor, and the governing differential equation for the mechanical system is given as J into d square theta by dt square plus B into d theta by dt, that will be equal to the torque. The back EMF of DC machine is always proportional to speed of the shaft, that is EB is proportional to d theta by dt, that is KB into d theta by dt. So the final, by substituting this in the equation, we'll get it as IA into RA plus LA into DIA by DT plus the back EMF will be equal to the armature voltage. Torque will be equal to KT into IA. So J D square theta by DT square plus B D theta by DT will be equal to the torque. Back EMF will be equal to KB into d theta by dt. On taking the Laplace transform for the above equations, we get IA of S into RA plus LA into S into IA of S plus EB of S will be equal to VA of S. So torque equation can also be taken Laplace. So TA of S will be equal to KT into IA of S. JS into JS square into theta of S plus B into S into theta of S, that will be equal to T of S. The back EMF EB of S will be equal to KB into S into theta of S. On equating these two equation, we get IA of S will be equal to JA square plus BS by KT into theta of S. So finally, the equation, that is the transfer function, is defined as the output to the input. Here output is the angular displacement of the motor, input is the armature voltage, that is given by the equation KT by RA into J into S square plus RA into B into S plus LA into J into S cube plus LA into B into S square plus KB KT into S. Thank you.